Hi everyone, I'm Dr. Samina, and today we're going to be talking about all about testosterone, how to know if you have high levels, what it really means for PCOS, and how to naturally reduce it in your body based on some of the research that we know with naturopathic medicine. So today, really, I wanted to focus on the fact that testosterone can be elevated in PCOS, primarily in the adrenal glands, but also can be elevated in the ovaries as well. So really, it's about learning about where the testosterone is coming from and then treating it based on lab results. So the reason why testosterone is high in the blood with PCOS is because oftentimes it comes from higher amounts of insulin in the blood. Insulin can actually drive the production of testosterone. So it's really important to get your insulin levels tested and also check to see if you have insulin resistance. This can be done with a fasting insulin and fasting glucose test, also HbA1c or an insulin glucose challenge test. And once you know if insulin is high, maybe that's kind of what is driving that testosterone production. But also, like, testosterone can come from the adrenal glands and be high in the blood as well. So it's really important to test different types of testosterone that we know of. The first is free and total testosterone. Free testosterone is just testosterone molecules floating around. Total testosterone includes testosterone free, but also bound to a protein called sex hormone binding globulin. There's also testosterone that comes from the adrenal gland. These are the glands that sit on top of the kidneys. They're small, like triangle shaped gland that helps us to produce our adrenaline, so like norepinephrine, epinephrine, and cortisol, which is our stress hormone. So when testosterone is coming from the adrenal glands, it's known as DHEA, and this is the testosterone that's primarily produced by the adrenal glands, and there's a small amount produced by the ovaries. The third one is androstenedione. This is a hormone that actually is produced by half by the adrenal glands and half by the ovaries. So, you know, what we're really trying to figure out is where this testosterone is coming from, and then based on that, use that knowledge to treat it. And lastly, the last testosterone form is called DHT or dihydrotestosterone. And this is the most potent form of testosterone in the body. It's actually produced from testosterone. So when we look at the hormone pathway, it goes like DHEAS creates androstenedione, androstenedione creates testosterone, and testosterone creates DHT. So and the conversion from testosterone to DHT uses something called 5-alpha reductase. And so when we talk about sal palmetto, this is a very strong herb that is referenced a lot in the literature in terms of reducing testosterone levels. It actually blocks 5-alpha reductase. So this is where we see if DHT levels are high, that it would work really well. Signs of high testosterone. So let me go back actually. So different types of testosterone, we said free and total testosterone. We said DHEA, S, androstenedione, and DHT. So these are the labs you should consider running or asking your healthcare provider to run for you. Some of the signs of high testosterone in PCOS include, you know, acne along your jawline, so this kind of area. Deep cystic acne is very common on your chest, on your back. Those are like some of the locations where we see testosterone related acne. Hair growth, so anywhere on your face, your chest, your breast area, your arms, your legs. Hair loss is also a common sign. So any of these signs can mean that you have high testosterone. So, and also it doesn't necessarily mean that you have to have high testosterone in your blood. As long as you have these signs of high testosterone, it means that you do have testosterone that is elevated. So let's see here. What I want to talk to you about, I just have a list. And this is also on an article that I wrote about. It's called Tired of Being Hairy All the Time. Learn about top 10 PCOS treatments for high androgens. So this is on my blog, so you can read about it. But I'm going to talk a little bit more in depth of some of these herbs that can be really helpful. So we had a conversation today a little bit about spearmint tea on the group. Spearmint tea has been researched in the literature to help reduce free and total testosterone. It was actually in the study, they had 3 cups of spearmint tea to help reduce testosterone levels, and that was daily. And so you can put all 3 tea bags into 1 cup of tea and drink that 1 cup. Or you can actually use 3 cups and drink it throughout the day. And also some of the other herbs, the 2 herbs that are used side by side or together are licorice and white peony. These are Chinese medicine herbs. And combined together, it actually inhibits the conversion from androstenedione to testosterone. So this means less testosterone circulating in the hair follicle. So therefore there'd be less growth and also less hair loss, because what happens is testosterone goes into the follicle, creates sebum, creates inflammation, and that's where we see hair growth or hair loss. So yeah, that's white peony and licorice. So in the studies, it was a 1-to-1 ratio of white peony and licorice, and that was shown to help reduce testosterone levels. And then when we talk about adrenal-focused androgens, so the androgens that are coming from your adrenal glands, where we produce cortisol, then it's really about figuring how to reduce your stress levels. So there's a few herbs and few things you can do to help reduce those levels. The first one is that I want to talk about that's not on the blog is called resveratrol. So resveratrol actually comes from the skin of a grape. And this is a very potent antioxidant, and it's been shown in the research to help reduce DHEAS, which is really cool. So if that level is high in your blood reports, then considering resveratrol as a supplement is would be good. And then L-theanine is actually found in green tea. So its main role is to help to balance this HPA axis. So HPA axis is hypothalamus pituitary adrenal axis. So the connection between the brain and the adrenal glands. And it really actually, it crosses the blood-brain barrier and calms the nervous system down. This is what I tell my patients all the time who like have these racing thoughts, worrying all the time. It's really great at using the nervous system or just calming the nervous system down. It won't give you lots of energy. It doesn't have any green tea in it. It's just an extract from green tea. Another one is phosphatidylserine. This helps to reduce cortisol levels in the blood. And so it can be really helpful if there's high stress, like you're feeling anxious all the time, worried, you're waking up with like a heart that's racing. Phosphatidylserine can also be helpful. And then let's talk about saw palmetto. So saw palmetto is one of the most used treatments, I would say, in my world for reducing androgen levels or testosterone. It's very potent, but it works. It's kind of like the Buckley's for PCOS because it tastes horrible. If anyone's tried it in tincture form, that's liquid form. So maybe capsules might be better. But basically what it does is it really helps to reduce testosterone levels. And, even from my personal experience trying it, I noticed that taking it daily, I see less hair growth and just overall just better, feeling better. Because really what's happening is when there's high testosterone, it's actually blocking your estrogen production. And when your estrogen is low, then that's when, you don't feel as well. You don't feel as confident, sexy, like you don't feel as good when you don't have as much estrogen. And so that's why reducing testosterone levels helps us in PCOS, because it allows estrogen to shine. And so saw palmetto can be really, really helpful in a case like this. I've used it for patients who have hair growth, hair loss, they're getting acne, but it really depends on kind of what your type of the symptoms that you're experiencing, and then using that to guide the treatment. Let me see if there's anything else I wanted to talk about in terms of this. Testosterone is really one of the key components of PCOS, and so it's really about figuring out, A, do you have insulin resistance that's driving testosterone production? Because if that's the case, we need to really change how you eat. B, if testosterone is high in the blood, we need to figure out where it's coming from. Is it from the adrenal glands where we produce cortisol, or is it from the ovaries? And if it's from the adrenal glands, then maybe we really need to give you botanicals that help to reduce stress. Okay, so these are things like L-theanine, the resveratrol, phosphatidylserine, and any adaptogens. These are herbs that help us to adapt to stress. So even the licorice would be good in this scenario. Or if it's coming from the ovaries, maybe we choose something like salt palmetto or white peony. That can really have an effect on the ovaries. So it's really about figuring out what's happening in the body and then treating it based on that. If you guys have any questions, please, please feel free to put them in the comments, and I'll be sure to answer them as soon as I can. I hope this was helpful, and I'll see you next week. Take care.